Good evening and welcome to Homestead's production of Oklahoma. We'd ask you to please refrain from flash photography. Just a reminder that this is a smoke-free zone and no smoking is allowed in the building or on the grounds. If you have to leave, we ask you to do so through the far north exit. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their head as they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
Hi, Aunt Ella.
Hi, Curly. What are you doing around here?
Come and sing it to you.
All the sounds of the earth are like music. All the sounds of the earth are like music. The breeze is so busy, it don't miss a tree. And an old weeping willer is laughing at me. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful day.
If I wasn't such an old woman, and if you weren't so young and smart, Alecky, I'd marry you and get you to sit around at night and sing to me.
No, you wouldn't neither, because I wouldn't marry you or none of your kinfolk.
Oh, none of my kinfolk, huh?
Yeah, and you can tell them that, all of them, including that niece of yours, Miss Laurie Williams. Say, Aunt Ella, if you were to tell me where Laurie was at, where would you tell me she was at?
I wouldn't tell you at all. Far as I can make out, Laurie ain't paying you no heed.
She don't take to me much, huh? Well, where'd you get such an uppity niece that wouldn't pay me no heed? Why, who's the best bronc buster in the territory?
You, I bet.
And the best bulldogger in 17 counties? Me, that's who. And looky here, I'm handsome, ain't I?
Pretty as a picture.
Curly-headed, ain't I? And bow-legged from the saddle for God knows how long, ain't I?
Couldn't stop a pig in the road.
And what else does she want from me then? The damn she-mule?
Well, I don't know, but I'm sure certain it ain't you. Who are you taking to the box social tonight?
Ain't thought about it much, really.
Bet you come over to ask Laurie.
And what if I did?
You asking me too, I'll wear my fascinator.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, thought you were somebody. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Is this all that's come a-calling out at 10 o'clock of a Saturday morning?
You know it was me before you opened the door.
No such of a thing.
You did too. You heard my voice and knowed it was me.
I hear the voice of talking rumbly with Aunt Ella and someone singing like a bullfrog in a pond.
Why, you knowed it was me. So you sitting there thinking up something mean to say. I'm a good mind not to ask you to the box social.
If you did ask me, I wouldn't go with you. Besides, how'd you take me? You ain't bought a new buggy with red wheels onto it, have you?
No, I ain't.
And the spanking team with the bridles all a jingling?
No.
Expecting me right behind old Dunn, I guess. You better ask that old Cummins girl over across the river you took such a shine to.
If I was to ask you, there'd be a way to take you, Miss Laurie Smarty.
Oh, there would.
Why not take you out tonight with me? Honey, here's the way it's gonna be. You will sit behind a team of snow-white horses in the slickest gig you ever see.
Lions!
Chicks and ducks and geese berskery. When I take you out in the Surrey, when I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top. Watch that fringe and see how it flutters while I drive them high-stepping strutters. Nose it pokes, so peek through the shutters and their eyes will pop. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With icing glass curtains you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. Two bright side lights winking and blinking, ain't no finer rig I'm a-thinking. You can keep your rig if you're thinking that I care to swap for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Would you say that fringe was made of silk?
Wouldn't have no other kind but silk.
Has it really got a team of snow-white horses?
One's like snow, the other's more like milk.
So as you can tell apart.
All the world will fly in a flurry when I take you out in the Surrey. When I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top. When we hit that road hell for leather, cats and dogs will play all together. Birds and frogs will sing all together, and the toads will hop. The wind will whistle as we rattle along. The cows will moo in the clover. The river will ripple out a whispered song and whisper it over and over. Don't you wish you'd go on forever? Don't you wish you'd go on forever? Don't you wish you'd go on forever? And it never stop in that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
You'd sure feel like a queen setting up in that carriage.
Only she talked so mean to me a while back, Aunt Ella. I'm a good mind not to take her.
Ain't said I was going.
Ain't asked you.
Where'd you get such a rig at anyway? I bet he went and hired a rig over Clamore thinking I'd go with him.
Shows all you know about it.
Spent all his money hiring a rig and now he ain't got nobody to ride in it.
Have too. Did not hire it. Made the whole thing up in my head.
What made it up?
Dashboard, no.
Oh, get off the place, you animal. Make him get himself out of here. Telling me lies. Get out of here.
Look out now. Say, ain't no law against making up a few putties that I know of. Don't you wish there was such a rig, though? Then you could go to that play party and do a hold down till morning, if you was a mind to. And then when you was all wore out, I'd come and lift you up on that Surrey and jump up alongside you, and we'd just point the horses home. Why, I can just picture the whole thing now. I can see the stars getting blurry when we ride back home in the Surrey. Riding slowly home in the Surrey with the fringe on top. I can feel the day getting older, feel a sleepy head near my shoulder, nodding, drooping close to my shoulder till it falls kaplop. The sun is swimming on the rim of a hill. The moon is taking a header
And just as I'm thinking all the earth is still, a lark will wake up in the meadow. Hush, you bird, my baby's a-sleeping. Maybe got a dream worth a-keeping. Whoa, you team, and just keep a-creeping at a slow clip, clop. Don't you hurry with the surrey with the fringe on the top.
Only there ain't no such rig. You just said you made the whole thing up.
Well,
why'd you come around here with your stories and your lies, getting me all worked up that way? Talking about the sun swimming on the hill and all like it was so. Who'd want to ride alongside of you anyway?
Why don't you just grab her and kiss her when she acts that way, Curly? She's just aching for you too, I bet.
Why, I wouldn't even speak to him, let alone now him to kiss me. The bragging, bow-legged, wish she had a sweetheart, bum!
She likes you. Quite a lot.
Phew! If she liked me anymore, Aunt Ella, she'd sick the dogs on me.
You get the wagon hitched up?
What wagon?
Oh, well, there's a whole crowd of folks coming down from Bushy Head tonight for the back social.
Curly said maybe you'd loan us your wagon to bring him up from the station.
Well, of course I would if you'd asked me.
Well, we got you talking about a lot of other things. I'll go get the horses hitched up to the surrey if you say it's all right.
Well, of course it's all right.
If I could ever get myself $50, I could have her.
$50? Is that what they give you for prize money?
That's what.
Lands, if Ada Wang's pa keeps his promise, we'll be dancing at your wedding.
And if it don't, I'll take her right from under his nose. Besides, I won't give him the present I brought him. Come here, boys, look what I got Ada Wang's pa.
Excuse us, Aunt Ella.
Like that. They call it the Little Wonder.
Well, I'm inside, baby.
Silly goats! Hussy! Oh, to be ashamed of herself. You two. Now, how do you turn this thing to see the other picture? Oh, wait a second. I'm getting it. I'm a good lie to tell Ada Annie on you.
Oh, please don't. You know she wouldn't understand.
No telling what you've been up to. Bet you carried on plenty in Kansas City.
Now, I wouldn't call carrying on. I sure to see some things I'd never seen before.
I got to Kansas City on a Friday. My Saturday, I learned a thing or two. For up to then, I didn't have no idea of what the modern world was coming to. I counted 20 gas buggies going by themselves almost every time I took a walk. But then I pulled my ear to a bell telephone and a strange woman started in to talk.
What next?
Yeah, what?
What next? Gallity round. Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They've gone about as far as they can go. They gone and built a skyscraper 7 stories high, about as high as a building ought to grow. Everything's like a dream in Kansas City. He's better than a magic lantern show. You can turn the radiator on whenever you want some heat. With every kind of comfort, every house is all complete. You can walk the prairies in the rain and never wet your feet. They've gone about as far as they can go.
Yes, sir.
They've gone about as far as they can go. Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They've gone about as far as they can go. They got a 50 theater they call the Burley Q. For 50 cents you can see a dandy show.
Gals?
One of them gals was fat and pink and pretty. As round above as she was round below. I could swear that she was padded from her shoulders to her heels. Till later in the second act when she began to peel, she proved that everything she had was absolutely real. She went about as far as she could go.
Yes, sir.
She went about as far as she could go.
What you doing, Will?
Well, they call it two-step. All the fellas are doing it. Waltz is out. Catch on? Of course, you can't do it alone. Come on, Anna.
And that's about as far as I can go.
Yes, sir. And that's about as far as she can go.
Hello, y'all, Sam.
And of course, there's someone a little near to home. Got her on his mind just about most of the time, till he don't know a plow from a thrashing machine.
Him?
Yes, Judd Fry.
That bullet-colored growly man!
Now, don't say nothing against him. Best hired hand I ever had. Just about runs his farm himself. Well, two women couldn't do it. You ought to know that.
Oh, Aunt Ella, Lord, go and take up with a man like that.
I ain't said she's stuck up with him.
Well, he's around her all the time, ain't he? Lives here.
Out in the smokehouse.
I changed my mind about being in the hen house tonight. I gotta quit early because I'm driving Laurie over to the party.
You're driving Laurie?
Just ask her.
Well, wouldn't that make you bald?
Well, don't you forget, Aunt Ella. Me and you's got a date together tonight. Say, if you make up a nice box of lunch, maybe I'll bid for it.
Connie, how are we going? In that rig you made up, I'll ride a trail and them lights are winking and blinking like lightning bugs.
That ain't no made-up rig. You hear me?
I went and hired it over at Claremore.
Lands, you did?
Sure did. Purty one, too. And when I come calling for you right after supper, you be sure and have your beauty spots fastened onto you proper, so you won't lose them off. You hear?
Say, that's a right smart turnout.
Hey, come! Tell all the girls in Bushyhead to stop by and freshen up a little. It's a long way to Skidmore's.
Will do. Say, I'll see you before tonight anyways, on the way back from the station.
Oh, that means we'll have lots of company. Better get your hamper packed now.
Aunt Ella, don't go to Skidmore's with Curly tonight. You do all have to ride with Judd all alone.
Well, that's the way you wanted it, ain't it?
No, I only did it because Curly was so fresh. I'm afraid to tell Judd I won't go, Aunt Ella. He'll do something terrible. You been down the old smokehouse where he's at?
Many a times. Why?
You see them pictures he's got tacked onto the walls?
Yeah, I see them. But don't you pay no mind to them.
Something's wrong inside of me, Aunt Ella. I hook my windows and fasten my door against it. Against it. The sound of feet are walking up and down under the tree outside my room.
Lord!
Mornings he comes to breakfast and looks at me from under his eyebrows like something in the back of the brush somewhere. I know what I'm talking about.
You crazy youngin. Stop acting like a chicken with his head cut off. Now, who do you reckon drove up? Why, it's that old peddler man, the one that sold me that egg beater. Do you want to know what that old peddler man told me? Told me that egg beater would beat up eggs, wring out dish rags, turn the ice cream freezer, and I don't know what all.
He's got Ado Annie with him.
Hold your horses, peddler man. I want to talk to you.
Hi, Aunt Ella.
Hi, yourself.
Hello, Laurie.
Hello. Will Parker's back from Kansas City. He's looking for you.
Will Parker? I didn't count on him being back so soon.
I can see that. Been riding a piece?
The peddler man's gonna drive me to the box social. I got up sort of a tasty lunch.
Ado Annie, have you took up with that peddler man?
Not yet.
But you promised Will Parker, ain't you?
Not what you might say promised. I just told him maybe.
Don't you like Will no more?
Course I do. They won't never be nobody like Will.
Then what about this peddler man?
They won't never be nobody like him, neither.
Well, which one do you like the best?
Whatever one I'm with.
Well, you are silly.
Now, Laurie, you know they didn't nobody pay me no mind up to this year, count of I was scrawny and flat as a beanpole. And then I kind of rounded up a little, and now the boys act different to me.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing wrong. I like it. I like it so much when a feller talks pretty to me, I get all shaky from heart to hoof. Don't you?
Can't think what you're talking about.
Don't you feel kind of sorry for a feller when he looks like he wants to kiss you?
Well, you can't just go around kissing every man that asks you. Didn't anybody ever tell you that?
Yeah, they told me. It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I knowed what's right and wrong since I've been 10. I heard a lot of stories, and I reckon they are true, about how girls are put upon by men. I know I mustn't fall into the pit, but when I'm with a feller, I forget. I'm just a girl who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix.
I always say, come on, let's go. Just when I ought to say nix. When a person tries to kiss a girl, I know she ought to give his face a smack. But as soon as someone kisses me, I somehow sort of want to kiss him back. I'm just a fool when lights are low. I can't be prissy and quaint. I ain't the type that can faint. How can I be what I ain't? I can't say no. What you gonna do when a feller gets flirty and starts to talk purty? What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that your lips are like cherries or roses or berries. What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that you're sweeter than cream and he's gotta have cream or die. What you gonna do when he talks that way? Spit in his eye? I'm just a girl who can't say no, can't seem to say it at all. I hate to disappoint a foe when he is paying a call. For a while I act refined and cool, a settin' on the velveteen settee. Then I think of that old golden rule and do for him what he would do for me. I can't resist a Romeo in a sombrero and chaps. Soon as I sit in their laps, something inside of me snaps. I can't say no. I'm just a girl who can't say no. Kissing's my favorite food. With or without the mistletoe, I'm in a holiday mood. Other girls are coy and hard to catch, but other girls ain't having any fun. Every time I lose a wrestling match, I have a funny feeling that I won. Though I can feel the undertow, I never make a complaint till it's too late for restraint. And then when I want to, I can't say no.
Like I told you, I get sorry for him.
Well, I wouldn't feel sorry for any man, no matter what.
Well, I'm sure sorry for Allie Hackam. Look how Aunt Eller's cussing him out.
Allie Hackam? That his name?
Yeah, it's Persian.
You sure for starting you love him better than you love Will?
I was sure, but not that old Will Parker has to come home and first thing you know, start talking purty to me and changing my mind back.
But Will wants to marry you.
So does Allie Hackam.
Did he ask you?
Not directly, but how I know is he said this morning when we was driving in his buggy that he wanted for me to drive like that with him to the end of the world. Well, we only drove as far as Catoosie. That'd take to sundown. And then we'd have to go somewheres and be on that together. And being together on that means he wants a wedding, don't it?
Not to a peddler, don't.
All right. If the egg beater don't work, I give you something new. Something just as good. Just as good? It's got to be 1,000,000,000 times better. My, oh my, Miss Lori, just look how you've grown up. Last time I come through here, you was tiny like a shrimp with freckles. Now look at you. You are a great, big, beautiful lady.
Oh, quit batting me. If you ain't had your breakfast, go eat yourself a green apple.
Now, Aunt Ella.
I ain't your Aunt Ella. Don't you call me Aunt Ella, you little what? I'm mad at you.
Oh, Aunt Ella, don't you be mad at me. Did I not say I give you a present? Perhaps something to wear?
foot. God for things to wear. Wouldn't have it. What is it?
Real silk. Made in Persia.
What would I need with an old Persian garter?
Oh, they look awful pretty, Aunt Ella, with bows on to them and all.
I'll try it on.
Stick out your foot.
Did you have any idea I was going to let you slide that garter on my limb? Hold on to my petticoats, Laurie.
You're a funny woman. Would have been much worse if I tried to take your garters off.
Yeah, because that would make your stockings fall down, wouldn't it?
Now, let me try the other one.
What other one? Oh, you want to buy this one too much.
What do you mean, do I want to buy it?
I suppose I can let you have it for 4 bits.
Do you want me to get that egg beater and ram it down your windpipe?
All right. All right. Now, don't anybody else want to buy something? How about you, Miss Lori?
A beautiful girl like you must want something.
Me? Of course I want something. Want a buckle made out of shining silver to fasten onto my shoes. Want a dress with lace. Want perfume. Want to be pretty. Want to smell like a honeysuckle vine.
Give her a cake of soap.
Want things I heard of and never had before. A rubber-tied buggy. A cut-glass sugar bowl. Not only things to look at and hold in your hands, but things to happen to you. Things so nice that they did happen to you, your heart would quit beating. You'd fall down dead.
I think I have just the thing for you. The elixir of Egypt.
What's that?
It's a secret formula used by the Pharaoh's daughter.
Smelling salts.
Yes, but a special kind of smelling salts. Read what it says on the label.
Take one deep breath, and you will see everything clearly.
That's what the Pharaoh's daughter used to do whenever she had a tough decision to make, like what dress to wear to a party, or what prince to marry, or whether or not you ought to cut off somebody's head.
Fiddlesticks!
I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Peddler.
Precious stuff.
How much?
I suppose I can let you have it for 2 bits.
Don't away your money.
Helps you decide what to do.
Now, Aunt Ella, won't you let me show you some doodads? You know, with the lace around the bottom and the ribbons running in and out.
You mean fancy drawers?
All made in France. Take a look at my finest.
Well, I don't wear those myself, but I sure do like to look at them.
Yeah, these are right if you ain't going no place.
Why don't you bring all your trappings inside and maybe we can find something for you to eat and drink?
Ask him why, don't you?
Allie? Me and Laura have been having an argument.
What about, baby?
About what you meant when you said that about driving me to the end of the world?
Well, I didn't exactly mean to the end of the world.
Well, then how far do you want to go?
Perhaps to Claremont, to the hotel.
Well, what's at the hotel?
Oh, my baby. In front of the hotel, there is a veranda. Inside of the hotel, a lobby. And upstairs, well, upstairs just might be paradise.
Well, I thought they was just bedrooms.
For you and me, baby, paradise!
Well, you see, I was right and Laura was wrong. You do want to marry me, don't you?
What did you say?
I said you do want to marry me, don't you? What did you say?
I said nothing.
One, two, three, yahoo! Ain't no Eddie, I'm back!
Oh, foot, just... No, Will! That's Will Parker. Promise me you won't fight him.
Why fight him? I never saw the man before. I only fight my friends.
Oh. Ain't no Eddie, how's my honey bunch? I'm the cutest 120 pounds of sugar in the territory.
Oh, Will? This is Allie Hackham.
How are you, Hack? Now, don't mind the way I talk. It's all right. I'm gonna marry her.
Marry her?
On purpose.
Why, sure.
No such of a thing.
Marriage is a wonderful thing, Will Parker.
Allie.
I have a brother in Persia who has six wives.
Six wives? All at once?
Why, sure. That's the way you do in them countries.
Well, not always. I have another brother in Persia. He only has one wife. He's a bachelor.
Look, Will.
Look, Will, nothing. You know what I got for first prize at the fair? $50.
Well, that was good. $50?
Catch on. Your pa promised I could marry you if I could get $50.
That's right. He did.
And you know what I've done with it? I've spent it all on presents for you.
But if you spend it all on presents, you ain't got the cash.
What I got's worth more than cash. Why, the fellow who sold me this stuff told me.
But, Will, I need to...
Stop saying, but, Will. When do I get my little kiss? Oh, wait, oh, Annie, honey. You ain't far off my mind since I left. Why, even at the fairgrounds, when I'd be roping steer, I'd rope him under the hoofs, and then I'd pull him sharp, and he'd land on his little old rump. And then I'd think of you.
Don't start talking purdy, Will.
Seen a lot of beautiful gals in Kansas City, and I didn't give one of them a look.
Well, how'd you see him if you didn't give him a look?
Well, I mean, I didn't look loving at him, like I look at you.
Please don't look like that, Will. I can't bear it.
I won't stop looking till you give me a little kiss.
What's a little old kiss?
Well, nothing. That's just coming from you.
You do talk purdy. No! No, I won't!
Supposing that I say that your lips are like cherries, roses or berries, what you gonna do? Can't you feel my heart palpitating and a-pumping, waiting for a something, something nice from you? I gotta have a kiss, and it's gotta be quick, or I'll jump in a creek and die.
What's a girl to say when you talk that way?
Wagon down to the trunk and give the team some water now.
Right away, Aunt Ella.
Oh, can I come too, Cuddy? Just love to watch the way you handle horses.
That's about all I can handle, I guess.
Oh, I don't think so. Not from what I heard about you.
Healthy and strong, love her like a baby if a man goes away, a weeping and a wailing how he's done her wrong. That's one thing you'll never hear me say. Never gonna think that the man I lose is the only man among men. I'll snap my fingers to show I don't care. I'll buy me a brand new dress to wear. I'll scrub my neck and I'll brush my hair and start all over again. Many a new face will please my eye. Many a new love will find me. Never have I once looked back to sigh of a romance behind me. Many a new day will dawn before I do. Many a light lad may kiss and fly. A kiss gone by is by gone. Never have I asked an August sky, where has last July gone? Never have I wandered through the rye, wondered where has some guy gone? Many a new day will dawn before I do. Many a new face will please my eye. Many a new too sorry of the romance behind me. Many a new day will dawn before I do. Never I chase the honeybee who carelessly cajole me. Somebody else just as sweet as he cheered me and consoled me. Never I wept into my tea over the deal someone told me.
Chance in the world you might change your mind?
No chance.
All right then. My heart is busted in two.
Oh, Allie, you do make up pretty things to say.
Hey, you ready?
Hello, Pop. What you been shooting?
Rabbits. That true what I hear about Will Parker getting $50?
That's right, Paul. He wants to hold you to your promise.
Too bad.
Still and all, I can't go back on my word.
See, I... Ellie Hackum!
No, I suggestion that you getting that money off him as soon as you can. Stick it in your stocking or in your corset where he can't get it off. Or can he?
But, Paul, he ain't exactly kept it. He spent it all on presents.
See, I knew it. Now he can't have you. I should have added me $50 cash.
What, Mr. Cotton?
Who the hell are you?
Well, this is Ally Hackum.
Well, shut your face or I'll fill your behind so full of buckshot. You'll be walking around like a duck for the rest of your life.
Ally, if I don't have to marry Will, maybe your heart don't have to be busted in two like you said.
I did not say that.
Yes, you did.
No, I did not.
Trying to make out my daughter to be a liar?
No. I am just making it clear to you how much of a liar I would be if she were telling the truth.
What else she been saying to my daughter?
Oh, an awful lot.
When?
Last night in the moonlight.
Where?
Alongside a haystack.
Listen, Mr. Cotton.
I'm listening. What else she been saying?
He called me his Persian kitten.
Why'd you call her that?
I do not remember.
I do. He said I was like a Persian kitten because they's the cats with the soft brown tails.
That's enough. In this part of the country, that better be a proposal of marriage.
That's what I thought.
Is that what you think?
Look, Mr.
I'm looking.
I'm a peddler. I move round and round the country. You'll never see your daughter no more.
That's okay, son. Just take care of her. Take care of my pretty little rosebud.
Oh, that's pretty, Pa. You sure for certain you can bear to let me go?
Are you sure, Mr. Cairns?
Just try to change my mind and see what happens to you.
Oh, Ally, ain't it wonderful? Pa making up our minds for us like that? He won't change neither. Once he says that you can have me, well, you got me!
I know I got you.
Mrs. Ally Hackum, the peddler's bride. Wait till I tell the girl!
Prat! Treat! Hoodblit! Ambushed!
Friend, what's on your mind? Why do you walk around and around with your hands folded behind and your chin scraping the ground?
20 minutes ago, I am free like a breeze, free like a bird in the woodland wild, free like a gypsy, free like a child. I am unattached. I'm minding my own business, like I ought to. Ain't meaning any harm to anyone. I am talking to a certain farmer's daughter. Then I'm looking down the muzzle of a gun.
It's getting so you can't have any fun. Every daughter has a father with a gun. It's a scandal, it's an outrage. How a gal gets a husband today.
If you make one mistake while the moon is bright, they tie you to a contract, so you'll make it every night.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, when the family surrounds you and say,
they gotta take and make an honest woman out of Nell. To make her make you honest, she will lie like hell.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, on a man, it's a plot. Where is the leader who will save us and be the first man to be shot?
Me?
Yes, you! It's a scandal, it's an outrage. Just a wink and a kiss and you're through.
You're a mess and in less than a year, by heck, there's a baby on your shoulder making bubbles on your neck.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. Any father will tell you it's true.
A rooster in the chicken coop is better off than none. He ain't the special property of just one hen.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, but there's gonna be a day.
We're going to win our liberation,
and you will lead the way.
Hey, okay.
your hair for now. I've been busy. Why, you got gooseberry tops, too. Wonder if they's as light as mine. Might have liked to throw the waves to blue on them.
I just did blow on one of mine a minute ago, and it broke into a million pieces.
Ain't she funny?
Betty, I think you better come inside and cool off now.
Coming inside with me, Curly?
Not just yet.
Well, don't be too long. And remember, when the auction starts tonight, mine's the biggest hamper.
So that's the Cummins girl I heard so much talk of.
Oh, well, you seen her before, ain't you?
Yeah, but not since she got so old. Never did see anyone get so peaked looking in such a short time.
Yeah, and she says she's only 18. I bet you she's 19.
Say, what you got in your hamper?
Oh, it's just some old meat pies and apple jelly. Nothing like good a Cummins has in her hamper.
Is it true what they're saying? That you're gonna go driving in that box social tonight with that Judd fella?
Reckon so, why?
Oh, nothing. Well, it's just that everybody's expecting me to take you.
Well, then maybe it's just as well you ain't. We don't want people talking about us, do we?
You think people really do talk about us?
Oh, you know how they air, like a swarm of mud wasps. Always got to be buzzing about something.
Well, what do you think they're saying? That you're stuck on me?
Uh-uh. Most of the talk's that you're stuck on me.
Can't imagine how these ugly rumors get started.
Me neither. Why do they think up stories that link my name with yours?
Why do the neighbors gossip all day behind their doors?
I know a way to prove what they say is quite untrue. Here's the gist, a practical list of don'ts for you. Don't throw bouquets at me. Don't please my folks too much. Don't laugh at my jokes too much. People will say we're in love.
Who laughs at your jokes?
Don't sigh and gaze at me. Your sighs are so like mine. Your eyes mustn't grow like mine. People will say we're in love. Don't start collecting things.
Like what?
Give me my rose and my glove. Sweetheart, they're suspecting things. People will say we're in love.
Some people claim that you are to blame as much as I. Why do you take the trouble to bake my favorite pie? Granting your wish, I carved our initials on the tree. Just keep a slice of all the advice you give so free. Don't praise my charm too much. Don't look so vain with me. Don't stand in the rain with me. People will say we're in love. Don't take my arm too much. Don't keep your hand in mine. Your hand feels so grand in mine. People will say we're in love. Don't dance all night with me till the stars fade from above. will see it's all right with me. People will say we're in love.
Say, Lori, don't you reckon you could tell that Judd fella you'd rather go with me tonight?
Curly, no, I couldn't.
You couldn't, huh? Well, then I think I'll go down to the smokehouse where Judd's at. See what's so elegant about him. Makes all the girls want to go to the parties with him.
Curly?
What?
Nothing. Don't sigh and gaze at me. Your sighs are so like mine. Your eyes mustn't grow.
Got your hamper packed yet?
Oh, Aunt Ella. Yes, nearly.
Do you like a hanky?
What I want with an old hanky?
You got a smudge on your cheek, just below your eye.
Open it, can't you?
Howdy.
What do you want?
Just got through with my business up at the house.
Thought I'd come pay you a call.
Say, you got a gun, I see.
It's a good one. Colt 45.
What do you use it for?
Shoot things.
Oh. See now, that there pink picture. Now that's a naked woman, ain't it?
Your eyes don't lie to you.
Plum stock naked as a jaybird. No, not quite. She's got a couple of thingamabobs tied onto her.
Shucks, that ain't a thing to what I got here. There, look at that top one.
Phew! I'll go blind. That'd give me ideas, that would.
That's a dinger, that one is.
Yeah, it sure is a dinger. Say, Judd, that's a mighty nice rope you got there. Spins nice. Say, you know Will Parker? He sure can spin a rope. Strong hook, too. You know, Judd, I reckon you could hang yourself from that.
I could what?
Hang yourself. Why, it'd be as easy as falling off a log. Fact is, you could use a log. Or a champion, rather. Right about here, see? Put this around your neck, good and tight. Tie it up there good first, of course. Then all you'd have to do would be to fall off the log. A chair. Whichever you'd rather fall off of. Why, 5 minutes or less, with good luck, you'd be dead as a doornail.
What do you mean by that?
Sure, and then folks would come to your funeral and sing sad songs.
Nah.
They would. You never know how many people like you till you're dead. You'd probably be laid out in the parlor. You'd be decked out in your best suit, your hair combed down slick in a high starch collar.
What day I'll be in the flowers, you think?
Sure would. Palms, too, all around your coffin. Then the folks would gather around, and the men would bare their heads, and the woman would sniffle softly. Some would probably faint. The ones that took a shine into you when you was alive.
What woman never took a shine to me?
Lots of women. Only they never come right out and show it. Unless you die first.
Oh, well, I guess that's so.
Yeah. They sure would sing loud, though, when the singing started. Sing like their hearts would break.
Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. All gather round his coffin now and cry. He had a heart of gold, but he wasn't very old. Oh, why did such a fella have to die? Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. He's looking oh so peaceful and serene,
and serene.
He's all laid out to rest, with his hands across his chest. His fingernails have never been so clean.
Then the preacher'd get up and he'd say,
"Folks, we are gathered here to moan and groan over our brother Judd Fry, who hung himself up by a rope in the smokehouse."
Then there'd be weeping and wailing from some of them women. Then the preacher'd say,
"Judd was the most misunderstood man in the territory. People used to think he was a mean, ugly fella, and they call him a dirty skunk and an ornery pig stealer.
But the folks that really knowed him know that beneath those two dirty shirts he always wore, there beat a heart as big as all outdoors.
As big as all outdoors.
Judd Fry loved his fellow man.
He loved his fellow man.
Judd Fry loved the birds of the forest and the beasts of the fields. And he loved the mice and the vermin in the barn. And he treated the rats like equal, which was right. And he loved all the little children. He loved everybody and everything in the world. Only he never let on, so anybody ever noted.
Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. His friends are weeping well for miles around.
Miles around.
The daisies in the dell will give off a different smell, because poor Judd is underneath the ground.
Poor Judd is dead, a candle lights his head. He's laying in a coffin made of wood. And folks are feeling sad, 'cause they used to treat him bad. But now they know their friend is gone for good.
Good.
Poor Judd is dead, a candle lights his head.
He's looking oh so pretty and so nice. He looks like he's asleep. It's a shame that he won't keep. But it's summer and we're running out of ice. Poor Judd.
Yes, sir. That's the way it'd be. Sure be an interesting funeral. Wouldn't like to miss it.
Wouldn't like to miss it, huh? Well, maybe you will. Maybe you'll go first.
Oh, maybe. Let's see now. Where'd you work at before you come up here? Up by, Quap Hall, wasn't it?
Yeah. Before that, over by Tulsa. Lousy there was to me there. Both of them making out like they was better than me.
Treat me like dirt.
And what'd you do? Get even?
Who said anything about getting even?
No one that I recollect. It just coming to my head.
Nah, if it came to getting even, I'd know what to do.
That?
Nah, the safer ways than that if you use your brains. For instance, do you remember that fire on the Bartlett farm over by Sweetwater?
Sure do. Terrible accident. Burnt up the mother, the father, and the daughter.
That weren't no accident. A feller told me that the hired hand was stuck on the Bartlett girl, and they found her up in the hayloft with another fella.
And it was him that burned the place.
Uh-huh. Took him weeks to get all the kerosene, buying it at different times. The fella who told me made out like it was in Missouri, but I knew all the time it was right on the Bartlett farm. What a liar he was.
And kind of a murderer too, wasn't he? Get a little Ann here.
I ain't told me what business they had coming here. We ain't got no cattle to sell, no cow ponies. The old crop is done spoke for.
You sure done relieve my mind considerable.
There's only one other thing on this farm that you might want, and it better not be that.
Oh, but that's just what it is.
It better not be. You better stay away from her, you hear?
You know, somebody ought to tell Lori once about the kind of man you are. And for that matter, somebody ought to tell you once about yourself.
You better get out of here, Curly.
A man wouldn't feel very safe around here with you, Judd, if he didn't know you. But I know you. There's two things you can do in this country if you're a man. Live outdoors is one, and live in a hole is the other. I've sit by my horse in the brush and hit a rattlesnake many a time. Rattle, 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 he'd go. Scared to death. Somebody's coming close to his hole. Somebody's gonna step on him. He'd get his old fangs ready, full of poison. Curl up and wait. Long as you live in a hole, you scared. You got to have protection. Or you can have muscles all like I and still be as weak as an empty bladder. Listen, you got something to bob your heart with. How'd you get to be the way you are anyway? Sitting here in this filth, the whole thinking the way you're thinking. Why don't you do something healthy once in a while? Instead of staying shut up here, crawling and... You ought to feel better now. Hard on the roof, though. I wish you'd let me show you something. There's a knot hole over there about as big as a dime. See it a-winking? I just want to see if I can hit it. Bullet right through the knot hole without even touching. Slick as a whistle. I knowed I could do it. You saw it too, didn't you? Somebody's coming.
Who fired off that gun? Was that you, Curly? Don't just sit there, you let me after when you're spoken to.
Well, I shot once.
What was you shooting at?
See that knot hole over there?
I see lots of knot holes.
Well, it was one of them.
Well, ain't you a party pair of nothings? A picking that way at knot holes and skinning everybody to death. Why, I ought to give you a good Dutch rub and iron some of that craziness out of you. It's all right, nobody hurt. Just a pair of fools swapping noises.
Hello, fellows. Mind if I sit and talk with you for a while?
Nice to get away from them women folk.
I got some parties to show you. Special for the men folk.
I'll see you gentlemen later. I gotta go pick up that Surrey I hired for tonight.
Art postcard.
Who do you think you're taking on that Surrey?
Ann Ella. Ann Laurie, if she'll go with me.
She won't.
Oh, maybe she will.
She promised to go with me, and she better not change her mind. She better not!
Well, John, I'd like you to take a look at these postcards, my new stock, all from Paris.
I'm sick of them things. You got any frog stickers?
You mean one of those long knives? What would you want with one of them?
I don't know. Kill a hog or a skunk. It's all the same, ain't it? Anyway,
I'd tell you what I'd like better than that if you've got one. You ever hear one of them things they call the little wonder? It's a little thing you hold up to your eyes to see pictures. Only that ain't all there is to it. Not quite. You say it's got a little jigger onto the end of it, and when you touch it, out springs a sharp blade.
On a spring, eh?
Yeah, you say to the fella, hey, look through this. And then when he's looking, you snap out the blade, it's just above his chest, and bang, down it comes.
Well, a good joke to play on a friend. But I'm sorry, I don't carry anything like that. It's too dangerous. But I would like you to take a look at these postcards.
I'm tired of them things. I want a real woman.
A real woman? Why? Why, I am having trouble right now, all on account of a real woman. Look at you. You are a man who is free to do as you please. You got a nice place. Private. Nobody to bother you. And artistic pictures. They don't talk back to you.
I'm tired of all these pictures of women.
All right. So you're tired of these pictures of women. Throw them away and buy some new ones. What can you do when you're tired of a real woman? Nothing. You just sit there and get tired of and tired.
I've made up my mind.
All right. So Judd Fry wants a real woman. Say, you ever hear of a girl named Edo Annie?
I don't want her.
Neither do I. But I got her.
I don't want nothing from no peddler. I want real things. What am I doing shut up here like that fella says, a crawling and a festering? What am I doing this lousy smokehouse?
The floor creaks, the door squeaks. There's a field mouse nibbling on a broom. And I sat by myself like a cobweb on a shelf, by myself in a lonely room. But when there's a moon in my window and it slants down a beam across my bed, then the shadow of a tree starts a-dancing on the wall, and a dream starts a-dancing in my head. And all the things that I wish for turn out like I want them to be. And I'm better than that smart alley cowhand who thinks he is better than me. And the girl that I want ain't afraid of my arms, and her own soft arms keep me warm. And her long yellow hair falls across my face just like the rain in a storm. The floor creaks, the door squeaks, and a mouse starts a-nibbling on a broom. And the sun flicks my eyes, it was all a pack of lies. I'm awake in this lonely room. I ain't gonna dream about her arms no more. I ain't gonna leave her alone. Going outside, get myself a bride. Get me a woman to call my own.
House
a dark club man.
Can you go somewhere else and tell fortunes? I gotta be here by myself.
Look, she bad at all smelling salts, but Peddler tried to stand up.
It ain't smelling salts. It's gonna make up my mind for me. Look at me take a good whiff now.
That's the cancer.
Please, girls, go away.
Why is it true you're letting Judd take you to the party? Not good.
Tell you better when I think everything clear. Beginning to see things clear already.
Well, I can tell you what you won't.
Out of your dreams and into his arms, you long to fly. You don't need Egyptian smelling salts to tell you what.
Out of your dreams and into the heart of calling.
Thank you.
Thank you. should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. One man likes to push the plow, the other likes to chase the cow, but that's no reason why they can't be friends. Territory folks should stick together.
Whether they're tied together in a huge network or acting as a personal assistant.
That's the righteous cows. Like to say a word for the farmer.
Well, say it!
He come out west to make a lot of changes.
He came out west and built a lot of fences. And built them right across our cattle ranges.
Why these dirt ranchers stay in Missouri? Where they belong?
Yeah, right. We got as much right here as anybody else!
Yeah. Yeah. Shut up! Farmer is a good and thrifty citizen. No matter what the cowman says or thinks, you seldom see him drinking in a barroom
unless somebody else is buying drinks.
The cowman should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. The cowman ropes a cow with ease, the farmer steals her butter and cheese, but that's no reason why they can't be friends.
Together, different folks should all be friends. Cowboys dance to farmers, cowboys, farmers dance to the ranchers'
girls.
Like to say a word for the cowboy.
That's right.
The road he treads is difficult and stony.
Yes.
He rides for days on end with just a pony for a friend.
I'm sure he feels sorry for the pony.
The farmer should be sociable with the cowboy. If he rides by and asks for food and water,
yeah, so
don't treat him like a louse, make him welcome in your house.
But be sure that you lock up your wife and daughter.
Who needs an old farm woman anyway?
That's right!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, it's terrible, you can get a square meal.
Yeah. Yeah. It's not that way about our women, folks.
Yeah. He can say what he wants!
Gonna slam out anything. This here's a party. Sing it, Andrew. Dum diddy dum dum dum.
Oh, farmer and the cowman should be friends.
Oh, farmer,
that's good.
Ouch.
Sing it.
One man likes to push a plow, the other likes to chase a cow. That's the reason why they can't be friends.
And when this territory is a state, like all the others, the farmer and the cowman and the merchant must all behave themselves and act like brothers.
I'd like to teach you all a little saying and learn the words by heart the way you should. I don't say I'm no better than anybody else, but I'll be damned if I ain't just as good.
Yeah, I don't say I'm no better than anybody else, but I'll be damned if I ain't just as good. Together, tender folks should all be friends. Cowboys, farmers, 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 and
thank you.
everybody. It's time to start the box social.
So hungry? I can eat a gatefold.
Who's going to be the auctioneer?
Why, Aunt Ella should be the auctioneer.
Let one of the men be the auctioneer.
That's right.
You know the rules, gentlemen. You got to bid last. You ain't supposed to know what good goes with what hamper. Of course, if your sweetheart has told you that hers will be done up in a certain kind of way with a certain kind of ribbon, well, now that ain't my fault. We'll auction off the hampers on the other side of the ranch and work around back. Follow me!
Hello, young fellow.
Oh, it's you.
I was hoping to meet up with you.
It seems you and I have a little something to talk about.
We only got one thing to talk about, Mr. Hackham. I hear you got yourself a geisha. Ain't no Annie.
Well, nothing.
I don't know what to call you. You ain't pretty enough for a skunk. You ain't skinny enough for a snake. You're too big to be a mouse. You're too little to be a man. I reckon you're a rat.
That's logical.
You just tell me one thing. Do you love her?
Because
if I thought you didn't love her, why, I take you up in this bag and I toss you in the river. Are you serious about her?
Yes, I'm serious.
You worship the ground she walks on like I do? You better say yes.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
The hell you do.
Yes.
Would you spend every cent you had on her? So that's what I did. $50. That's all I had in the world.
So you're telling me if you had $50 cash...
I'd have Ada Wanny, and you'd lose her.
Yes, I'd lose her. And let's see what you got in this bag. I might want to buy something.
Now what would you want with that stuff?
I'm a peddler, ain't I? I buy a nice, might pay you real money. Maybe as much as, well, a lot. Say, what a beautiful water bottle. It looks French. Must have cost you plenty. I can give you $8 for it.
$8? Well, that wouldn't be honest. Now we pay $3.50.
All right, then. I say $8, I give you $8. Let's see what else you got in here. This.
Ho.
Say, now that's a crackerjack.
Keep your hands off that. That was for our wedding night.
It don't fit you so good. I can pay you $22 for it.
No, I don't know.
All right, then, $22.50. But not a penny more. Now, what else you got in this crazy? Oh. Say, what a beautiful ankle brace.
No! Don't them for her to wear!
I didn't figure they were for you. Mighty dainty. I pay you $15 for those. Now, let's see. You get your $22. You got your $8, that makes $30, and 15 and 50 cents, that makes $45.50.
$45.50, huh? Well, that's almost. Say, you want to buy something else, Mr. Hackham?
I might.
Did you ever see one of these?
What made you buy one of those? Got it in for someone?
What do you mean? Just a girl in pretty pink tights.
There's more than that to it.
Where's everybody? Where's Aunt Ella?
Well, I think she went to the other side of the ranch.
No, I went you wrong, too.
Now, how much are you going to give me for this thing?
I'm sorry. I don't handle things like that. Too dangerous.
What do you mean? Just a girl in pretty pink tights.
Father, you two seen it, all right?
Well, I think she went to the other side.
Now, John. Here's one of those things you were looking for. The little wonder.
How much? How much? $3.50.
That's a lot of money. But I got an idea that might be worth it.
That means I got $50, ain't it?
No, you've only got $49. You're $1 short.
Must have figured wrong. How much must I have in this bank?
$1.
Sold! I got $50 now, ain't I?
You certainly do.
And you know what that means? It means I'm gonna take 801 back from you.
No! You wouldn't do that to me!
Oh, I wouldn't, would I? When I tell her Pa who I got most of the money off of, maybe he'll change his mind about who's so smart and who's so dumb.
Say, fella, you're certainly buckled me.
Come on, gather round. Don't be shy. Now, here's the last two hampers, and who's the heir? I ain't got no idea.
Well, the big one's mine, and the little one's Lawrence.
Well, that's the end of that secret. What am I bid for Ado Annie Tampa?
2 bits. 4.
Who says 6? You, Slim? Ain't nobody hungry no more? What about you, Peddler Man? 6 bits?
Nah, come on.
6 bits.
6 bits ain't enough for lunch like Ado Annie can make. Let's hear Dollar. What about you, Mike? You won it last year.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, Ado Annie, you got that same sweet potato pie like last year?
You bet!
Same old sweet potato pie, what do you say?
Well, I say it gave me a 3-day bellyache.
Never mind that, who bids a dollar?
Come on.
Mine's the last bid, I just bid 6 bits!
Bid a dollar!
90 cents.
90 cents, we're getting rich. Another dance for the schoolhouse. Do I hear any more?
Here, $50.
What? $50? Nobody ever been $50 for a lunch before. Nobody ever been 10.
He ain't got $50.
Oh, yes, I have. And if you're a man of your word, you gotta say it when it belongs to me.
That ain't your money. You just bid it for the schoolhouse. Which means I got to say the peddler man still gets my daughter's hand.
Now, wait a minute, that ain't fair!
Going for $50, going
$51.
You crazy? 50! Wait a minute. If I don't bid my money no more, I can keep it, right?
Sure can.
That means I still got $50. This is mine!
You feeble-minded shy pope!
Going for $51, going! Go! Oh! That means Ado Annie will get the prize, I guess.
And I get Ado Annie.
What are you getting for your $51?
A 3-day bellyache?
Now, here's my niece's hamper. I took a peek inside here a while ago, and I must say it looks mighty tasty. What do I hear, gents?
2 bits. 4 bits.
What do you say, Slim? 6?
I bid $1.
That's more like it. Do I hear 2?
$4. $2.
$2.50.
$3.
And 2 bits.
$3 and 4 bits.
$4.
And 2 bits.
$4.25. Ain't I gonna hear any more? We got a bit of 4.25 from Judd Fry. You wanna let him have it?
4.5.
4.5. Going for 4.5. Going?
4.75.
4.75. Come on, gentlemen. Schoolhouse ain't built yet. Got to get us a nice chimney.
$5.
$5. Going for $5.
And
going.
2 bits.
2 bits for my blood. Can't afford anymore.
Come on. Ain't got nearly enough yet. Not for cold duck with stuffing and lemon meringue pie.
$6.
$6. Going for $6. Going.
2 bits.
Ah, you're stubborn, Judd. Mr. Collins is a richer man than you. And I know that he likes custard with raspberry sauce. Ain't nobody gonna bid no more?
No, they all dropped out, can't you see?
You got enough, Dan L.
Let's get on.
Here's the money.
Hold on! I said go in.
Well, say it!
Go into Judd Fry for $6.02. Go in.
Who'd you say was getting, Laura?
Judd Fry.
And for how much?
6.25.
Now that ain't quite enough, now is it?
It's more than you've got.
I got a saddle here, it cost me $30.
You can't bid saddles, it's got it for cash.
A $30 saddle must be worth something to somebody. I'll give you 10.
Don't be a fool, boy, you can't make a living without your saddle.
You got cash?
Right in my pocket.
Let's not waste time. How you going?
Harder than you no matter what.
All right then.
Aunt Ella, I'm bidding all this $10 might just give me.
Going for $10. Going.
$10 and 2 bits.
Early?
You boys all know my horse. Done. She's kind of a nice horse. Gentle and well broke.
Please don't sell Dunn, Curly. It ain't worth it.
I'll give you 25 for it.
All right, I'll sell Dunn to you. And all of that makes a bid $35.
Curly, you're crazy. But it's all for the schoolhouse. All for educating and learning. Going for $35. Going.
Hold on. I ain't finished bidding yet. You just put up everything you had in the world, didn't you? You can't bid the clothes on your back because they ain't worth nothing. You can't bid your gun because you need that. Yes, sir, you need that bad. So, Anilla, I guess I'm just as reckless as Curly McLean. Just as good as getting what I want. So I'm going to put up everything I've saved in the world for 2 years doing farm work. All for naught. So here it is. Forward at $2 and 31 cents. Anybody want to buy a gun? You, Dave, just bought a brand new last Thanksgiving.
Worth a lot.
Please don't sell your gun, Curly.
I give you $18 for it. Sold. Aunt Emma, that makes a bid $53. Anybody going any higher?
Go! Ain't nobody gonna cheer nothing!
That's right. The farmer and the cowman should be friends. Now, you lost the bid, but the bidding was fair. Go on, cowboy, shake the farmer's hand.
Sure. I'll shake hands.
That's better.
Say, Curly, I got something I'd like to show you. Excuse us, Lord.
You ever hear of a thing they call the little wonder?
Just what is it?
Well, it's a little thing you hold up to your eyes to see pictures. Like this, you see.
Let me see.
Curly! Oh, Curly! What are you doing?
Doing? Nothing much. My God, what are you go squealing at a man like that for? Scare the liver and lights out of a fella.
Well, stop looking at them old French pictures and ask me to dance. You brought me to this party, didn't you?
All right, I'll dance with you. Dance with you all over the meadow if you want, you silly old woman.
Play us the music, Shelby.
Well, Aunt Eleni, I got my $50, or you name the day.
August 15th.
Why August 15th?
Why, that was the first day I was kissed.
It was? Why, I don't remember that.
You wasn't there.
Now, look, Aunt Eleni, we gotta have a serious talk. I mean, you gotta stop having fun with other fellas.
You've got to be a little more standoffish when fellas offer you a buggy ride.
I'll give an imitation of a crawfish and dig myself a hole where I can hide.
I heard how you were kicking up some capers when I was off in Kansas City Mall.
No!
I heard some things you couldn't print in papers and from fellas who've been talking like they know.
What? I only did the kind of things I order. Sorta, to you I was as faithful as can be. For me, those stories about the way I lost my bloomers, rumors, a lot of tempest in a pot of tea.
The whole thing don't sound very good to me.
Will you see?
I go and spend my last wild oat, I cut out all shenanigans. I don't spend my money, don't gamble or drink at the back room down in Flanagan's. I give up lots of other things a gentleman never mentions. Before I give up any more, I want to know your intentions. Well, With me, it's all or nothing. Is it all or nothing with you? It can't be in between. It can't be now and then. No half and half romance will do. I'm a one-woman man, home-loving type, all complete with slippers and pipe. Take me as I am or leave me be. If you can't give me all, give me nothing. And nothing's what you'll get from me.
Not even something.
Nothing's what you'll get from me.
It can't be in between. It can't be now and then.
No half and half romance will do.
Will you build me a house all painted white, cute and clean and pretty and bright?
Big enough for two but not for three.
Supposing that we should have a third one,
he better look a lot like me.
Stop image.
He's gotta look a lot like me.
But if a wife is wise, she's gotta realize that men like you are wild and free. So I ain't gonna fuss, ain't gonna frown. Have your fun, go out on the town. Stay up late and don't come home till three. And go right off to sleep if you're sleepy. No use waiting up for me. No use waiting up for me.
Thought you wanted to dance.
I want to talk to you. What made you slap that whip on the old lady and nearly make her run away? What was your hurry?
Afraid we'd be late for the party.
Nah, you didn't want to be with me by yourself. Not a minute more than you had to.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm with you by myself right now, ain't I?
Well, you wouldn't have been if you could have got out of it. Morning, you stay in your room all the time. Nights you sit in the front room when you won't get on any other sight. Why, the last time I seen you alone, it was winter. It was snow, 6 inches deep in drifts. When I was sick, you brought me that hot soup out to the smokehouse and you give it to me.
And me in bed, I hadn't shaved in 2 days. You asked me if I had any fever. You put your hand up to my head to see.
I remember.
Do you? I'll bet you don't remember as much as me. I remember everything you ever done, every word you ever said. I can't think of nothing else, you see? Do you see how it is? I ain't good enough, am I? I'm a hard hand. I got dirt on my hands, pig slop. Well, I ain't fitting to touch you, because you're better. So much better. We'll see who's better, Miss Laurie. Then you wished you wasn't so free with your airs. You're such a fine lady.
Hey, you making threats to me? Hey, you standing there trying to tell me if I don't allow you to slobber all over me like a hog, why are you gonna do something about it? Why, you're nothing but a mangy dog. Somebody ought to shoot you. You think so much about being a hired hand? Well, I'll tell you something that'll rest your brain, Mr. Judd. You ain't hired hand for me no more. You can just pack up your duds and scoot. Well, I ain't got better ideas than that. You ain't to come on the place again, you hear me? I'll send your stuff any place you say, but don't just as much set foot inside the pasture gate, or I'll stick the dogs onto you.
You said your say. I can't help it. I can't never rest. I told you the way it was, and you just wouldn't listen.
Who's that?
Why, it's me, Laurie. Have you seen Ada Wanny? And she's run off again.
Will, could you do something for me? Go find Curly and tell him where I'm at. I want to see Curly awful bad. Gotta see him.
Then why don't you turn around and look, you crazy woman?
Oh, Curly!
Well, you found yours. Now I gotta find mine. What on earth is ailing the Bella Claremore? By gum, if you ain't crying.
Curly, I'm afraid of my life.
Jumping toadstools. Great Lord.
Don't you leave me.
God almighty.
Don't mind me crying. I can't help it.
Oh, you cry your eyes out.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Here. I'll show you. About all a man can stand in public.
Oh, you don't like me, Curly?
Like you? My God. Go away from me, I tell you. Plumb away from me.
Whew. Curly, you're sitting on the stove.
God almighty! Oh, it's as cold as a hunk of ice.
Wish you'd have burned a hole in your pants.
You do you?
You hear me.
Now, look at here, Laura. You stand over there where you are, and I'll sit over here. And you tell me what you wanted with me.
Well, Judd was here. He scared me. Never met nobody like him. Talked wild and he threatened me, so I fired him. I wish I hadn't, though. There's no telling what he'll do now.
You fired him, huh? Well, that's all there is to it, then. Well, I'll get you a new hired hand in the morning. I'll stay in the place myself tonight, if you're afraid of that old hound dog. Now quit your worrying, or I'll spank you.
Say, Laurie, while I think of it, how about you marrying me?
Gracious, what I want to marry you for?
Oh, well, don't you think you can maybe think of some reason why you might?
Well, I can't think of none right now, hardly.
Lord, please, ma'am, marry me. Oh, I don't know what I'm going to do if you don't.
Oh, Curly, well, I'll marry you if you want me to.
Oh, I'll be the happiest man alive as soon as we're married. Oh, I got to learn to be a farmer. I see that. Quit thinking about throwing the rope. Get my hands blistered a new way. Things is changing right and left, Laurie. Buy your mow machines. Cut down the prairie. Shoot your horses. Drag them plows under the sod. They're going to make a state out of this here territory. They're going to put it in the Union. Countries are changing. Got to change with it. Bring up a pair of boys. New stock. Keep up with the way things is going in this here crazy country. Now I got you to help me. Oh, I'm out to something yet.
I remember the first day I ever laid eyes on you. It was at that fair. You were riding that great filly of blue stars, and I says to someone, who's that skinny little thing with a bang hanging down over her forehead?
Yeah, I remember. You was riding the Bronx that day.
That's right.
And one of them throwed you.
That's right. Did not throw me.
Guess you jumped off then.
Sure I jumped off.
Yeah, well, you sure did.
Say, if there's anybody out around this here yard that can hear my voice, I want for them to know Laura Williams is my girl.
Curly.
And she's went and got me to ask her to marry me.
They're here all the way to Catoosa.
Let her.
Let people say we're in love. Who cares what happens now?
Just keep your hand in mine. Your hand feels so good in mine.
Let people say we're in love. Starlight looks well on us. Let the stars beam from above. Cares if they tell on us. Let people say we're in love.
Well, Edwani, I'll be saying goodbye here.
To drink to Curly and Laurie.
It is time for the lonely gypsy to go back to the open road.
I wished I was going. Then you wouldn't be so lonely.
Edwin, there is a man I know who loves you like nobody ever loved nothing.
Yes, Allie Hackam?
That is the man that will stay with you for the rest of your life. Also, the man for you, Will Parker.
Yeah. Well, I like him a lot.
Of course you do. He is strong like an ox, young and handsome.
I love him all right, I guess.
Yes, you do. You love those crystal blue eyes of his and the way his mouth wrinkles up when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love him because he makes my Edwani happy. But now I must be going. But first, let me show you how we say goodbye in my country of Persia.
That was goodbye?
We have a song in Persia that goes something like this. One goodbye is never enough.
Hello, Will. Me and Allie was just saying goodbye.
Ah, Will, I'd like to say goodbye to you, too.
Don't, no, you don't. I just saw the last one.
Look at you two. You are made for each other.
You be good to her, Will. And you be good to him. You don't mind now.
I'm friend of the family.
Didn't you say you was going?
Ah, yes. But first, Will, let me show you how we say goodbye in my country of Persia. She's a beautiful girl, Will. I wish it was I marrying her instead of you.
Don't seem to make no difference, hardly.
I must be going. It is time for the lonely gypsy to go back to the open road.
Now that peddler man's gone, you ain't gonna think of him no more, are ya?
Of course not. Never think of no one unless he's with me.
Well, I ain't ever gonna leave your side.
Well, even if you don't, even if you never go away on a trip or nothing, Can't you, once in a while, give me one of those Persian goodbyes?
Persian goodbye? Well, that ain't nothing to an Oklahoma hello.
Hollering with the rest of us. I never seen you stay so sober at a wedding party before.
And scared all night, Judd Fry come up and stop for Curly.
Why, Judd Fry's been out of territory for 3 weeks now.
No, he ain't. I saw him up at Claremore last night, drunk as a lord.
Let's have 3 cheers for the happy couple. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
That lass had gone for a golden wedding.
But if you married her, you must have wanted to.
Oh, sure. Sure, I wanted to marry her. I wanted to marry her when I saw the moonlight shining down on her father's shotgun. I figured it would be better to be alive. Now I ain't so sure.
Say, Curly, was you scared when the preacher said you take this here one?
Why? Well, I was scared he wouldn't say
it. They couldn't pick a better time to start in life.
It ain't too early yet, it ain't too late.
Start Claire's mama with a brand new wife.
Soon be living in a brand new state.
Brand new state, gonna treat you great.
Gonna give you barley, carrot and potatoes.
The cattle,
spinach and tomatoes.
Flowers on the prairie where the June bugs zoom.
Plenty of air and plenty of room.
Plenty of room to swing a rope.
Plenty of heart and plenty of hope.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oh, Oklahoma, every night my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky.
We know we belong to the land,
and the land we belong to is grand.
And when we say,
yeah,
are you fine, yo, yeah,
we're only saying, you're doing fine, Oklahoma, Oklahoma, okay.
Team hitched up for the service for me?
Well, have it in a jiffy.
Cussing, never hurt anybody.
It ain't gonna be rough, is it?
No, it ain't. Now just stop gabbing about it.
Seems like there are times when men ain't got no need for women.
Well, there's times women don't have any need for a man either.
Yeah. Yeah. No, but who wants to be dead? Hey, Will, did you hear the news? Gertie married the peddler.
Well, I'm mighty glad to hear that, Mr. Peddler Man. Maybe I ought to kiss the bride. Hey, Gertie, you ever had an Oklahoma halo?
Come back.
Where do you think you're going?
Well, I'm going to stop Beta Wayne from killing your wife.
Hey, you mind your own business.
You bunch of pig stealers!
Come on down peaceably, Laura Sugar.
You do, you cut ahead of cowboy!
Will you give one your chin?
Come on, fellas, let's get him back!
First, I want to kiss the bride. Oh, here's my present for you.
My God! He fell on his own knife!
Roll him over, somebody.
Don't touch him!
What's the matter?
Don't touch him! Is he breathing? Roll him over.
Steal his heart. How'd it happen?
What do we do? Ain't he all right?
Is he just done?
Get away, some of you. Let me look at him.
Colonel, is it?
Don't say anything.
Can't be that way.
I didn't go too.
Can't be like that to happen to us.
Come on, some of you. Let's get him over to Dr. Tyler.
Here, some of you, carry him over to my rig. I'll drive over to Dr. Tyler.
Aunt Ella, I gotta go see if there's anything that can be done for Judd. You keep an eye on Laura for me.
Maybe it's better for you and Curly not to go away tonight.
I don't see why this had to happen when everything was so fine.
Oh, don't let your mind run on it.
Can't forget, I tell you. Never will.
That's all right, Lori, baby. If you can't forget it, just don't try to, honey. Oh, lots of things happen to folks. Sickness or being poor and hungry, even. Being old and afraid to die. But that's the way it is, cradle to grave. And you can stand it. There's one way. You gotta be hearty. You gotta be. You can't deserve the sweet and tender life less than you're tough.
I wish I was the way you were.
Fiddlestick, scrawny, you know. You couldn't hire me to be the way I am.
What would I do without you? You're such a crazy.
Sure as your bone.
They've taken him over to Dave Tyler's till the morning.
Is he alive?
Laura, honey, this is Court Elam. He's a federal marshal. And he thinks I ought to give myself up. He thinks I ought to give myself up tonight.
Tonight?
Why, your train leaves Claremont in just 20 minutes.
The best thing is for Curly to go on his own accord and tell the judge.
Why, you're the judge, ain't you, Andrew?
Yes, but...
Tell him now and get it over with.
Oh, we can't do that. You have to do it in court.
Well, let's just do it here and say we did it in court.
Oh, that wouldn't be right. That's breaking the law.
Let's not break the law. Let's just bend it a little. Come on, Andrew, we haven't got but a minute. Let's get this trial out of the way.
Andrew, I got to protest.
Shut your face. Now, we can give this boy a fair trial without locking him up on his witness. Now, here's the long and the short of it. What's your plea? Well, that means, why'd you do it?
Why'd I do it? Well, that Judd fella, he'd been pestering Laura, and I was
just a minute, Don't want your tongue wobbling around your mouth like that now. Well, just tell me, what happened tonight and made you kill him?
Well, you all seen it. He come at me with a knife, and I just...
All right, get all right. That's only self-defense.
Wait.
Now, is there anyone here who saw this happen?
Andrew, I feel funny about it. I just feel funny.
You'd feel funny if I told your wife you were carrying on with another woman, wouldn't you?
I ain't carrying on with no one.
Well, maybe not, but you'd sure feel funny when I tell your wife you are.
That's not funny. As a federal
marshal. Shut up about your being a federal marshal. We ain't gonna let you send this boy to jail on his wedding night. We just ain't gonna let you.
Come on, fellas. Let's pull them to their train at Curly Surrey. And we'll be the horses.
Yeah. Just a minute. I ain't getting the verdict yet.
Well, the verdict's not guilty, ain't it?
Well, yes, but...
Well, then say it.
Not guilty!
Court's adjourned.
Why, ain't Annie, where have you been?
Will and me had a misunderstanding. But he explained it fine.
Say, the prime crew ready yet?
Here we come.
Another beautiful day.